I remember people telling me this book was everywhere. Everybody had this book. It was on every student's table because it was very cheap and accessible. Today, students want to see buildings, they go online, right? But you, I always tell my students today that you have to remember that in 1977, you couldn't just open the computer and see what was built around the world. My research started when I was doing my PhD research here in London, and I met Charles Jencks, a very, very important voice in the discourse on postmodernism. I was very also interested in this book that he published in 1977, which is The Language of Postmodern Architecture. Postmodern architecture is characterized by many things, but first of all by a reaction against the sort of orthodoxy of modernism. It's also characterized by playfulness, by irony, by a mixture of high culture and low culture, and by meaning, which is what Jencks insisted on particularly. So meaning in architecture, that architecture is a language that should speak to both the specialist but also the layman. What is really interesting with Charles Jencks is that he builds the Cosmic House at the same time as he publishes The Language of Postmodern Architecture. So I think the ideas that he puts in the book and that he develops with the different editions are also developed in the house physically. It's full of symbolism. That was something that was very important to Charles Jencks. So one of the things that he did with the house is to design the progression between the room as a cycle of seasons. So you get in by the living room, which is winter, then you move slowly into spring. The dining room is summer, then you move into the kitchen, which is Indian summer, and finally autumn with a little sofa where I'm sitting right now. The house is really a manifesto for postmodernism, and it was also Jencks' private residence, but it was also a meeting point. It was also a place where architect would meet, and the idea with this foundation now is the house is not just a museum. It's pretty important for my research to be in the house, and I think it's an incredible opportunity that the archive is host in the house, in Jencks' library, so in the place where he used to work. I think there are maybe two or three researchers that have been in the archive so far, so I'm one of the first one, and I do the research as the cataloging and the sort of kind of sorting out of the document is happening. So it's new discoveries every time I come, let's say. I knew about this thesis, but I was quite excited to find the original thesis, Modern Architecture, the Tradition Since 1945 by Charles Alexander Jencks. The seeds of the ideas that are in the language of postmodern architecture are already there. You know that it's his copy. It has obviously a passing of time. Probably most of these images are also pictures he took himself. Yeah, you feel, I would say, very close to your object of research when you find this kind of document. As a next step in this research, I think it's important for me to talk to people who have actually used the book when they were young architects, so as to get a more personal aspect of my object of study and a more personal vision. I do work a lot with oral history, so that's a good way to do that, and I would like to see also how the book was used in different countries, different contexts, how it traveled. So I think this is a next step in the research.